In this age of the 12-step, 10-step Korean skincare routine, is less really more? I'm gonna show you my 5-step morning skincare routine that takes me under 5 minutes to do, and you can do it too. Let's get into this fun AM skincare. Do you know that for me, this is one of the hardest videos for me to record because I have a bare face and I'm so self-conscious about my skin because I have so many imperfections. I have age spots. Look at my dark circles. I mean, I don't know if you, I kind of have to go out, but they're so dark. That's why I focused on makeup because I love the way that makeup transforms me. But in order to have beautiful makeup, you have to have beautiful skincare. This is Lacey. I don't show her very often, but right now she's intrigued because she sees some lights on the ceiling of my bedroom. She really loves a little spotlight or a little, you know, laser light to play with. She's a chunk and she is my lovey girl. So she is an easy, easy dog and I don't show her often enough, but this is Lacey. And yeah, let's get into the skincare routine. Okay, into the morning skincare. It doesn't have to be 12 products. If you enjoy that, go for it. Do what you want to do. But recently, I have really kind of stepped back and I wanted to know what products were being super effective. And you don't have to get these products. You know, if there's products that you're already using, you go ahead and use those. If you love them, just, you know, stick with it. That's one of the things that I'm learning about skincare is I don't necessarily want to change my skincare up every time I turn around. And I have so many companies that approach me about trying their skincare and I want to, but at the same time, if I'm onto something that I really love, I'm not necessarily going to run out and get the latest and greatest. My favorite thing in my skincare routine is water. It's distilled water in a spray bottle. Nothing too fancy about that. Okay, I just sprayed into my hand because the sprayer is a little bit intense and I just put that across my face. This is before I start washing or anything. I'm just kind of getting my face wet in preparation to loosen that skin up. And I kind of just really kind of wake my face up. Don't be afraid to rub your face. I don't think there's anything wrong with rubbing your face. You don't want to get, you know, crazy with it. But when you get massages that bring the blood supply up to your face, you really, you know, they really use a lot of pressure. Okay, after I do that, I use the Pixi Skin Treats Hydrating Milky Peel instead of a cleanser. That's because this is super gentle and it doesn't have those stiff grains in them that you know, whatever they're called. I always say granulars and that sounds weird to me, but those little grains that you get that just kind of, you know, make your face feel like it's being rubbed raw, that doesn't have that in it. I'm not exactly sure what it has in it. It just feels like it's really just sloughing away everything. So you're definitely getting like a texture in this product, but you're not getting anything that is going to make your skin feel raw or anything like that. It's just a milky consistency. It's extremely hydrating. It feels really good. I really like it. I don't mind bringing it up underneath my eyes. Although if I'm noticing some eye makeup from the night before, I will go ahead and take that off with something else before I start this. Occasionally, I will do a chemical peel. I like this because it's so gentle and I can use it every single morning. All right, just a regular washcloth and I go across. I like using washcloth because this also will do a little bit of exfoliating. Paula of Paula's Choice, the founder of that company, is a firm believer that the only exfoliating that you need that is the physical exfoliant is simply from a washcloth. And I like both, so you can go either way with that. So I just go ahead and take all of that off. It doesn't leave any residual behind. I love that about it. Then I will go into the bathroom and I'll splash some water on my face. So I'm gonna go do that. Now, if you just want a good suggestion for a cleanser instead of using this milky peel, I Ride or Die CeraVe, whether you use the hydrating one or the gentle foaming one, you know, whether you have dry skin, whether you have regular combo, oily, whatever, there's a cleanser for you from CeraVe. I find that it's super affordable and it's super effective. So I just love it. It's really, really good. The hydrating one is perfect for my dry skin. I didn't plan for this to have two products from Pixi, but I do happen to be using up a big Mac Daddy of the Pixi glycolic toner. I love this stuff. This is glow tonic, I should say, but it's got glycolic acid in it. And I believe it's about 5%. I love this. Pixi did send this to me. It's all beat up because I put it in and out of my little bin that I have, but it used to say Melissa's Glow Tonic. I love that they sent that to me and that they thought of me. It was so sweet of them to do that. So I do really love this. This is the bottle that I'm using up right now. But honestly, if I was going to suggest something to anyone, it would be the Ordinary Glycolic Acid Toning Solution that is in 7%. This is so good. And I like them both. This one doesn't have a fragrance and this one does. The Glow Tonic has been so many people's ride or die for so long. So if you love it, stick with it. But you're going to save quite a bit if you go with the Ordinaries. It's quite less expensive and it has a little bit more glycolic acid in it. I'll tell you why I love glycolic acid in the morning. It's because it makes my face feel so soft. And so after I'm done cleansing and getting all of that skin off, this will help to loosen skin up even more if you need that. But for me, it just helps prep my skin for everything else that I'm gonna put on it. And I really like that. So I just use one squirt in my hand. I don't use a cotton round. I don't like to waste my products with cotton rounds. And I just kind of got away from that a few years ago. And I just find that it just gets all the product on me instead of in the cotton. And don't forget to go on the back of your hands. That's what I didn't talk about when I was cleansing. Lately, I've got a lot of questions about my hands. Now, I don't have the young looking hands. They're just normal. They don't have a lot of age spots and stuff on it because anything that goes on my face goes on my hands, including my retin-A. And I just make sure that whatever treatment I'm doing to this from, you know, my décolleté up goes on my hands and up my arms as far as I can take it, you know, so, you know, I'm just pushing everything up. I'm really rubbing it into my hands when I'm done. Okay, after putting on that toner, taking it all over my hands, I go in now with my Niacinamide Brightening Toner from Good Molecules. I love this. I've been using it ever since it came out a couple years ago. This is formulated with niacinamide, vitamin C, alpha arbutin, licorice root to brighten and improve the appearance of enlarged pores. When I originally got this, within 2 to 3 weeks, I was noticing a difference in the size of my pores. And I was feeling like my pores were really diminishing. And I was just shocked. I was like, am I imagining this? And I've told this story before, but Mary from Glitzy Fritzy, she said the same thing in one of her videos, like in the same month. And I was like, it's not just me. All right, this stuff works. And again, I just pour it into my hand. It's very watery. It's like a toner. It's that consistency toner essence. I really like using this consistency because I feel like it doesn't build up anything on my skin. If I'm using a lot of serums or a lot of lotions, I feel like they don't sink in as well as all the other stuff that I use that are essences or toners. So I really, really love this product. And I did immediately notice a difference in my pores. Now it took a while for it to brighten and I feel like it really did. Nothing's gonna brighten my dark circles except for makeup. So I really enjoy this. I love it. I buy it over and over again. I buy it in the 3 or 4 pack, whatever they sell. And I love it. And if you want to, you can go in with another vitamin C serum if that's what you like. I would absolutely say that vitamin C is so important, antioxidant. I feel like I get enough in this, but if you're somebody that wants a little bit more, go ahead and do a vitamin C serum. And then my next step is moisture. I use from Sukoyaku Suhada. This is the moisture, what they call lotion. It's not lotion, it's an essence. But for me, because of my dry skin, this is worth it, 100% worth it. This is a urea product. And I say this again every time I talk about my products that I love. And I don't switch up a lot. You're gonna find that when I do a lot of skincare videos, you're gonna find a very repetitive theme of it being something for aging, for brightening, or for hydration, because my skin is so, so dry. So I apologize to my oily skin gals, but those other two products, the glycolic acid and the niacinamide toner, are definitely for my oily skin girls as well. If you are normal to combo anywhere in there, this routine is just fine for you. If you're super oily, these two steps that I'm going to show you next are the ones that will be a little bit, you know, tricky. Now, as I'm talking so much here with you, I know that you're thinking, this is not a 5-minute routine. This video is 12 minutes long, or however long it's going to be. That's because I wanted to specifically tell you what these products all do. Okay, again, it's water. I've just pat it and push it into my skin. But this is so hydrating that this is my final moisturizing step. A lot of people have a cream and that's fine. But I find that putting this on as my last step I'm hydrated all day, but if you're somebody that really likes creams at the very end, there was one from Radiant Soul that I had in my empties video that I just loved. It was such a light, airy cream, but super hydrating, and I really liked that. Okay, this one is available from Sukoyaku Suhara. This is the eye cream. This cream has been my holy grail ride or die eye cream for I can't tell you how long. I use a pretty generous amount, large size P amount, and I go in and I really smother my eyes with this because I have super crepey, super dry under eyes, actually all around my eyes. And I will also push this into my lips so that it gets that lip area and hopefully those vertical lines a little bit plumped up. Now that's it, except for SPF, which we know is so, so important. If I'm going to be in my home, I just use the Revlon ColorStay Prep and Protect Primer Base. This has an SPF of 34 in it, and I love this. And so this will be my next step as far as I don't have to do a primer when I'm getting ready for makeup because this does have a little bit of the dimethicone in it, but it's a mineral based, which is so lovely. I'm using a lot. It's a mineral based and it has the SPF in it. And I really love this. It's one of those ones that I purchase over and over and over again. And I make sure that I always have an extra of it set aside because I just really love it. It's a really great one. And then I will use that same amount for my neck and my décolleté. And I didn't talk a lot about my neck and my décolleté. I usually do. I usually always talk about the neck area. You can use another sunscreen for the back of your hands. I just happen to have this one sitting here. What's beautiful about this sunscreen and the primer as well is it does have a little bit of that dimethicone in it. So it's gonna help smooth out your pores for makeup. It will create a barrier between your makeup and your moisturizer. So your foundation isn't melting with your moisturizer and kind of sinking into your skin throughout the day. I really love that about it. But on days that I'm going to go out and I know I'm going to be in the sun, I will use just specifically an SPF separate. And I've been enjoying this one as we're getting into warmer months. I've been enjoying this one from CanMake. Now it's an SPF of 50 and it's called Mermaid Skin Gel. I really enjoy it. It plays so well underneath my makeup. It's just beautiful underneath my makeup. So many SPFs will just ball up on me, but this one doesn't. It's very light feeling. It feels like it sinks into the skin quickly, and I just really like it. And so, you know, if you're looking for something that is separate from your primer instead of having the two combined, I think that you will really like this. That's it. I know that I talked a lot, but honestly, there's not that many steps in here. I just cleanser or exfoliation. I use the exfoliation. And then it is my glycolic toner. It is the niacinamide toner. It is the urea toner that I use for my lotion. And then it's an SPF. Use the eye cream too. So if you want to get technical, it's 6, but it's 5 steps as far as cleanse, tone, treat, moisturize, and then sunscreen. So I can do this in about 3 to 4 minutes. It doesn't take that long. The longest that anything takes is just me getting that dead skin off my face. And what helps so much is to put that water on first, loosen up the skin, go in and do your thing. And one last thing, I've been enjoying City Lips. I put this on to plump up my lip lines and it helps out so much. This is a pricey little number. This does go on sale quite often, which I will put on my Instagram and my Facebook page when they do. They just had a sale and I wasn't feeling good enough to be able to post. That's my morning skincare routine. Go ahead and tell me in the comment section what you do in the morning that you just absolutely love. Maybe it's a little bit of pampering. Maybe it's a little extra serum or something that you can't live without. I would love to hear that because I do like trying things out even though I'm getting kind of stuck where I'm at because it's so effective for my skin and my skin type. I love you guys very much. Please take care of yourselves and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye.